FM 92.7 needs your money. Have you considered sponsoring a programme? We have extremely competitive rates and can reach your target audience.
Good afternoon and welcome to Sheldopedia. I'm Sheldon Betteridge here on today's show. We're going to talk about the YouTube restructure need for an unequal health system, plus giving live updates on the vaccines after I played Arcade by Duncan Lawrence on Sheldopedia on Arrow FM.
A broken heart is all that's left. I'm still fixing all the cracks. Lost a couple of pieces when I carried it home. I'm afraid of all I am. My mind feels like a foreign land. Silence ringing inside my head. Please carry me, carry me, carry me home. I've spent all of the love I saved. We were always a losing game. Small town boy in a big arcade. I got addicted to a losing.
That was Arcade by Duncan Lawrence on Sheldopedia on Arrow FM. And that song was initially number one in the Netherlands in 2018 after the Eurovision Song Contest. Won by him, but resurging popularity as if thanks to a fire hit through the TikTok. And it's gaining chart traction across the world. Health Minister Andrew Little says the government is preparing urgently to restructure health system that is under stress and riven with inequalities. Cabinet will next month decide how we'll overhaul the health sector and set a budget at four sectors as a leader at Parliament on Wednesday morning. Little set the scene for coming changes. The system is under stress now and the situation is only going to worsen without reform. Little told the crowd they are tucked into a cooked breakfast. Since becoming health minister in November, Little has signaled he wants to move faster on the health sector. With one's federal government initially in fires after receiving a hefty health and disability system review in June 2020. On Wednesday, he emphasized the government's intention to create a more helpful society as recommended by the review, and said it will play a more active role than previously considered, not simply monitoring and advising. Addressing inequalities is not about creating an advantage, there's no advantage from being sicker and dying younger, he said. In a speech, Little did not mention the prospect of creating an overarching health system agency called Health New Zealand that would act as an overseer of a country's district health boards, DHBs. Nor did the mention of recommendation slashing a number of DHBs from 20 to between 8 and 12. And the policy relations would decide the DHB board members. Speaking to reporters, after he converted both HC and the DHB restructure will be on cabinet table in the coming month. He would weave together all the operating parts of the disparate elements are in place to deliver great consistency and greater cohesion across the system, he said. When he announced the specifics about the structure, you'll see the role has been mandated for Health NZ. In the speech, said via every 2 seconds, someone says the GP of New Zealand, 1.2 million people are hospitalised each year, 220,000 work in the sector, yet in a detailed case for change. Little said that some dietary people are closer working to die of a preventable illness than others. And in the lowest performing DHBs, near a third of people want more than 62 days of cancer treatment, he said. It's not good enough for our health system to be for most, if the outcomes for others are less of a postcard health lottery as well, document. He said beyond the creation of my health authority, the government have 4 other priorities. These are protective funding for better primary and community care, hospitals and specialised care works in a single system, digital technology actually works and delivers healthcare in the long-term planning for the stressed healthcare workforce. With the COVID-19 pandemic shows us that a whole system faces the same crisis, it can respond. It can change the way it operates. So like more telehealth, more remote engagement and that stuff. Now stuff makes a difference, he said after the speech. What have I received in the last few months is kind of slipping back to the old practices. So you want a structural system to signal what you want as a pair of ventures and features in the way of services are delivered. The Simpson Review. The government in June 2020 committed an overhaul of our health system, broadly accepted the discretion of a health and disability system review, which took a team of experts led by a healthy communist health system 2 years to complete. But while the government had accepted a principal review, the direction of travel for roadmap was murky. Now unencumbered by coalition partners after a landslide 2020 election with the height of a COVID-19 pandemic response behind it, the Labour government is due to decide how it will proceed. Among the wide-ranging recommendations of a Simpson review was asked for 2 new health entities to be created. First, Health New Zealand would eventually take operational responsibilities away from Ministry of Health, given our ministry greater ability on focus to policy work and population health. Health NZ will be an overseer of our country statutes, will provide public health services to communities. Second, will be a creation of Murray Health Authority, which will consider all things Murray in the health sector, which will aim to fix the significant inequality in the health outcomes of a Murray face. Other recommendations include wing fees of DHB, if I've had one, goes to tier 1, will primary or community services, so it can be allocated elsewhere, and that increases health sector funding in the government's budget guaranteed through the use of a formula that takes into account the shifts of the population. The review said that the disabled New Zealanders assistance should not be contingent on diagnosis, but instead focus should be on assisting the people to live well according to their needs. This is what has to say.
That's the score.
Say in that video report. That's terrible. The next song I will be going to play is... it is going to be... Your Love 9 p.m. by 80, followed by Imagine Dragons.
You know I got your number all night. I'm always on your team, I got your back, alright. Taking those losses if it treats you right. I wanna put you into the spotlight. If the world would only know what you've been holding back. Heart attacks every night. Oh, you know it's not right. I will follow you way down, wherever you may go. I follow you way down to your deepest low. I'll always be around, wherever life takes you. You know I follow you. Call you up, you've been crying all night. You're only disappointed in yourself, alright. Taking those losses if it treats you right. I wanna take you into the sunlight. If the world would only know what you've been holding back. Heart attacks every night. Oh, you know it's not right. I will follow you way down, wherever you may go. I follow you way down to your deepest low. I'll always be around, wherever life takes you. You know I follow you.
To give herself enough love, she live a life hand in a tight glove. I wish that I could fix it, I could fix it for you,
but instead I'll be right here coming through.
That was Follow You by Imagine Dragons on Sheldopedia on Arrow FM. The government has set out a criteria for people who will be led to a front of a queue in the COVID-19 vaccinations. This might not blogging, one of our health priority categories is executive are for people who need to be vaccinated to go overseas over for important events or where will represent New Zealand. For compassionate grounds, COVID-19 Minister Chris Higgins said the government has many to come up with a list. And a high threshold has been said, which will balance conversation with the need to avoid potential key jumping ahead of a risk groups without strong justification. Fair profession will not extend to vaccination for new arrivals or returnees. People need to be a New Zealand citizen resident or visa holder who needs to travel before 31st of August 2021 to get exemption, but also book a return trip to New Zealand. Compassionate exception will include needing to provide critical care for protection for the defendant getting a medical care that is not available in New Zealand or visiting a dying relative. That does not include reunited with family, attending a funeral or memorial service, or attending school or university, Hipkins said. But other category is for people who need to go overseas on matters of national significance. These people who need to travel in an official captivity, likely diplomats, trade negligators, people involved in humanitarian operations, or people who are going to attend significant international events, potentially many sports people. There's also exception for people traveling attend an event in an official non-government captivity. The key yardstick here is people traveling within official captivity and enjoying their participation is in our national interest. We also expect these requests will be made by an appropriate agency or association on behalf of an individual, not by individual themselves, if it does not include private or recreation travel, Hipkins said. COVID-19 Minister Chris Higgins discussed of likelihoods of sports people. Including the biggest would qualify to get early vaccinations. And what will National Party actually think about it? We're to find out in a video.
Exceptions to the vaccine rollout plan that we announced 2 weeks ago. We've confirmed quite strict and a very carefully considered criteria for early vaccinations for people who need to travel outside of New Zealand on compassionate grounds or for reasons of national significance. A very high threshold for early access to vaccines has been set, which will balance compassion with the need to avoid potential queue jumping ahead of at-risk groups where there is no strong justification for that. Even before people will be considered for early access to vaccines, they'll need to satisfy a series of criteria, including being a New Zealand citizen, resident or visa holder, needing to travel before the 31st of August, and having already made arrangements to return to New Zealand after their travel. They will also need to ensure, as far as practically possible, that they are able to receive both doses of the vaccine before their scheduled departure. The compassionate grounds that will be considered for travel overseas include needing to provide critical care and protection for a dependent, accessing critical medical care that is not available in New Zealand, and visiting an immediate family member who is dying. It does not include reuniting with family, attending a funeral or memorial service, or attending a school or university. National significance overseas travel will include representing New Zealand in an official capacity, at significant international events, and in an official non-government capacity. The key yardstick here is that people are travelling in an official capacity, ensuring their participation is in our national interests. We expect these requests will be made by the appropriate agency or association on behalf of individuals, not by individuals themselves. That's for the latter category. It will not include private or recreational travel. The final consideration is the level of risk travellers will be exposed to around COVID-19 in their destination country. Underlying these decisions is a fundamental recognition that while there are legitimate and urgent reasons to travel overseas, it's also in our interests to ensure that New Zealanders are protected against COVID-19 to the best extent possible for when they return home to New Zealand.
Does this mean you'll vaccinate the black caps?
Look, they'll have to make an application. It will depend on what sort of events they were participating in as to whether they fit, you know, whether they fit the national interest criteria. But certainly, our expectation is that the Olympians would be eligible under the national interest criteria, and a national sports team participating in a significant event would also meet those criteria. My understanding is that we're talking about a few hundred potential athletes and sports people who might fit the category. So it's not a large group, but certainly where that national interest or national significance criteria is met, then yes, they would be able to.
I guess the key word there is significant, isn't it? Because the World Test Championship and the Olympics and Paralympics are obviously significant, but is canoe polo, is trapping, what does it matter whether you're in a big sport or a small sport?
Yes, it has to meet that national significance criteria. So obviously those sports that everybody is hanging out to watch on television, for example, are more likely to hit the national significance criteria than a school sports team going to compete with someone else around the world.
Be urged. Do not go there if you are sick, if you attended funerals or go to schools and education, because only go there when it's a unisonous exemptions are include needing critical care protection of a department getting medical care that is not available in New Zealand or visiting a dying relative and it's looking good for us because I really wanted to go back to Australia later this year. So, next song I will be playing, Fire Fire with Fire by Metallica on Sheldopedia on Arrow FM.
Thank you.
That was Fight Fire with Fire by Metallica on Sheldopedia on Arrow FM. FM, the fresh metal track from 1984 is proof you can be a metalhead in an instant. Right. Sexism in Australian politics is very concerning. With Scott Morrison says he's listening to women once media fails sit in glass houses. Physical, emotional, angry stemming from him.
Across this building and indeed right across the country. Women who have put up with this rubbish and this crap for their entire lives, as their mothers did, as their grandmothers did. I have the deepest of vested interests. Criticise me, if you like, for speaking about my daughters, but they are the centre of my life. My wife is the centre of my life. My mother, my widowed mother, is the centre of my life. They motivate me every day on this issue. They have motivated me my entire life. They have taught me the values and the faith that sustains me every single day in this job, which is why I'm here. I owe them everything. And to them, I say to you girls, I will not let you down.
If you were the boss of a business and there'd been an alleged rape on your watch, and this incident we heard about last night on your watch, your job would probably be in a bit of jeopardy, wouldn't it? Doesn't it look like you've lost control of your ministerial staff here?
Well, I'll let you editorialise as you like, Andrew. But if anyone in this room wants to offer up the standards in their own workplaces by comparison, I'd invite you to do so.
Well, they're better than these, I would suggest.
Let me take you up on that. Right now, you'd be aware, in your own organisation, that there is a person who has had a complaint made against them for harassment of a woman in a women's toilet. And that matter is being pursued by your own HR department. You're not aware of it. So let's not, all of us who sit in glass houses here, start getting into that. You're free to make your criticisms and to stand on that pedestal, but be careful.
Rape culture, it should not never happen in Australian politics and should not happen everywhere, because that is not right. For something more disappointed, saying facts is no such investigation or report had been made, and that Morrison had conflated other reports. Former Prime Minister Malcolm Turnbull said Morrison's press conference has been too much about him, not being about women who have been victims of sexual assault harassment. Story on Australian news show 10 News First. They even have story far much worse. Right, something more even bad. After recording a year with a low level of public mass shootings in more than a decade, for US suffered a second such incident less than a week on Monday night, with a shooting at a Colorado grocery store killed 10, including one police officer. Joe Biden stressed for shooting on Tuesday, calling for swift legislation to be passed, and once again lowering for White House flag to have staff after he called to be lowered after last week's mass shooting in Atlanta. The president called on Congress to close the loopholes in the background check system and to once again ban assault weapons. He specifically urged the Senate to pass the two background checks bills that the House approved earlier this month. I do not need to wait another minute, let alone an hour, to take the common sense that will save lives in the future. Biden said this is not, it should be on a partisan issue. It is an American issue. It's unclear whenever bills won't make it through the evenly divided Senate, given Republican general opposition to gun restrictions. Asked whenever Biden was considering executive action to address gun fires, the White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki said the president was considering a number of options. There's an ongoing process, and I think we have to work on our multiple channels at the same time. Psaki said gun safety advocates, including Barack Obama, also called for immediate action to Congress to address the resurgent national epidemic as the country emerges from a year of lockdowns and disease by the coronavirus pandemics. In the remarks for the White House, Biden called for a new ban on assault weapons and high capacity magazines, said via Senate should immediately pass legislation to close loopholes in the background check system for the purchase of guns. The Republican minority in the Senate is highly likely to block any action on gun control. Nevertheless, senators on the Democratic side echoed Biden's call to action. This is a moment to make our stand now. Twitter said a Chris Murphy from Connecticut, where a shooter killed 26 people at an elementary school in 2012. A male suspect was released in the scene. Ken Soper's grocery store in Boulder, Colorado. He has named on Twitter as worth 10 victims. This is a tragedy and nightmare for Boulder County. And for response, we have cooperation and assistance from local, state, and federal authorities and Boulder County District Attorney Michael Daughtry. The Colorado attack brought this week's death toll from a mass public shooters to 18 other gunmen, killed 8 people at the 3 Atlanta area bars last Tuesday. 6 of the victims were women from Asian descent. The attack produced national demand for reckoning with discrimination and violence directed at Asian Americans. While racist fate goated by Donald Trump and others sparked faster attacks against Asian Americans during America's pandemic year, death penalty was unusually quiet for one of the public mass shooters, according to a database maintained by Associated Press USA Today. Northeastern University bureau team such as in 2018 and 9 in 2018, according to a database that looks at public incidents with which at least 4 died, not including the shooter. The U.S. only suffered only 2 such incidents in 2020, both start of the year before this. Spread of a coronavirus, which led to local economic and school shutdowns related to restrictions. Gun sales surged during a pandemic, leading to the return of mass gun violence under coronavirus restriction ease. Those fears have been vilified already. We have a horrible year as a country, as a world. Colorado says Senate majority to see the feedback a Democrat in its NBC. And as far as I feel like things are getting back to normal, and unfortunately we remind me if that includes mass shootings. But Colorado police officer killed in a Colorado store attack, Eric Talley, who is 51 years old, father of 7 children, who was first responsible, reports of shots fired. And the store authorities said the attack just days after the judge blocked Boulder for enforcing a 2-year-old ban on assault weapons at a large capacity magazines in the city. According to that, only Colorado state or federal can prohibit for possession, sale, and transfer of assault weapons. Large capacity magazine wrote for County Judge Andrew Hartman, according to the Denver Post. While no state untouched by mass shootings, Colorado has an especially difficult history of such incidents, beginning with an attack on students for high school in Colorado in 1999 that killed 13 in our 2012 gunman fired at a crowd watching a bet. Man, movie killing 12, wounding 58. As previously scheduled, the Senate Judiciary Committee held a hearing on Tuesday on constitutional common sense steps to reduce gun violence, gun safety, legislation via the gay treasurer in Congress. Despite a wide public argument about certain safeguards such as universal background checks. To say the end of senseless killers, we need more force and prayers. We need more federal action on gun safety in the Senate. We need it now. John Faber is president of Irritel Gun Safety Fed. We began on this hearing. We cannot risk until we pass background checks into law. Maybe he does not sit on a committee who has been mounting nearly 50 health foul person on the Senate floor to advance gun safety legislation after 49 people died in a mass shooter at a gay nightclub and further called on colleges to address gun violence. Murphy involved shooting in Boulder, a mass shooting in Florida High School in 2018, killed 17 of a mass shooting at a Sandy Hook Elementary School in Newtown, Connecticut. No more new towns. No more parklets, no more boulders, he tweeted. Now we make our stand. Next song I will be playing, it is it will be the track from 1976, which is Sweet's Love Like Oxygen on Sheldopedia on on Sheldopedia on Arrow FM.
Thank you.
Pearl's Lifeless Like Oxygen by Sweet on Sheldopedia on Arrow FM. Right, going to tell you the top 10 happiest countries of last year for coronavirus, what a year of fear of anxiety, loneliness and lockdown, illness and death, and an annual report on happiness around the world released on Saturday suggested the pandemic has not crushed on people's spirits. The editors of the 2021 World Happiness Report found while the margins changed as the pandemic set in, the longer-term satisfaction with life was less effective. What has found when the people had taken long for have shown a lot of resilience in this past year. As one of the reports co-author said from New York.
This is ROFM, Wairarapa's only community access radio.
For fourth consecutive year, Finland came out of the top for the United States, which was number 13 5 years ago. Has slipped from number 18 to 19th place, thanks to Trump's mishandling and denies that they will go away in a miracle. On a shortened list of ranked other countries surveyed, for US placed 14th. I'm gonna tell the top five of it. Mama Finland, number two. Number 10, Austria. Number 9, New Zealand. Number 8, Luxembourg. Number 7, Sweden. Number 6, Norway. Number 5, Netherlands. Number 4, Iceland. Number 3, Switzerland. Number 2, Denmark. And Finland, you knew us at number 1. And I'm going to play a song from the 1980s, which we'll be going to play. It will be level 42, Lessons in Love.
I'm not proud, I was wrong, and the franchise du mal. Qu'avec ta religion, où sont tes fidèles? Si tu es contre Dieu, tu es contre l'homme. Sale, es-tu diabolique ou divin?
That was Sadness Part 1 by Yungma on Sheldopedia on RFM. Before that, it was Level 42's Lessons in Love. The fact of the day, it is Facebook has 40,030 full-time employees as of September 30th, 2019. Final song of the day, it is Walking for Light by The Dudes on Sheldopedia on Arrow FM.
Thank you.
Fat whilst working in a lot, both the dudes on Sheldopedia on RFM. That's it for Sheldopedia. Hope you have an excellent time. I'll see you next Friday. Bye bye. This is Sheldopedia on Arrow FM.